I think I've talked about this on the blog before, but this picture, and if I have, it's worth repeating again. This picture is kind of a representation of why lighting and time of day is so important in a photograph. If you scroll down just a bit, you'll see the same scene, not the exact same flowers, but the same scene from, I don't know, it was the same bed of flowers from the day before. So my coworker and I took a short break. We walked around Theta Pond here on campus, which is like, I don't know, 300 yards from our building. And I saw these flowers. And on the original picture, the one that you see below, I thought I would try and get a picture. And I did. I mean, it's okay. There's nothing special about it. But I noticed that the lighting is really harsh and overhead. And it was probably like 2 p.m. And you get these colors that are nice and distinctive. So there's white, there's the white flower petals, the nice orange of the flower middle, whatever that's called, the greens. You can even see a blue sky. But it's so harsh and contrasty that it just, it didn't look as good as it could. So I kind of made a mental note. And then the very next day, I came back to work with my camera, specifically with the purpose of taking, sort of retaking the same picture, only in better lighting. And I went to that bed of flowers and I took several pictures until I found this one here. And I thought it was kind of cool the way that you can see this one flower sticking up. I've titled this Ambition because I imagine that this one flower is sort of reaching for the sky. Well, the rest of the flowers are too busy looking all around them. This one flower is looking above at all the possibilities, and it's a new day and all this stuff that, I mean, it's a flower. I'm sure it's not thinking anything. But it kind of made a cool image seeing it do this unique thing that the rest of the flowers weren't doing. And behind it, you can see that clearly there's a lot of light going on, and that's the early morning sun being, I don't know, what is it being reflected off of something? I forget. But, it's coming. I'm actually looking into the sun, and it's coming through the trees, the vertical parts that are dark of the trees. And in a way, this picture is a bit of a failure because it's not very well micro-composed. The flower should really be in the fully within that dark area of the picture that is actually a big tree. As it is, it kind of the left-hand side at about maybe 10 o'clock on the, if this were a clock face, cuts into the bright area with the sunlight. And I don't like how it kind of ruins the image of the flower a little bit, because you have this very bright light blending in with the white of the flower petals. And to me, it takes what could be a good photo and it lowers it just a bit. And it's another lesson, another thing to learn. There's nothing wrong with it. But to me, as I learn more and more about micro composing, thanks to the Sam Abel talk that I've linked to once again on the blog, the more I want to try and do this in my own photography. So if nothing else, this is a lesson to me to learn how to micro compose and do that a little better. And I would challenge anyone listening to this to focus not on just the overall composition, but on the micro level of composition when it comes to taking your pictures.